It would be easy to pretend that domestic violence isn't happening, but it is happening to your friends, to your family, to your neighbors, to your coworkers, to you. Let's shine a light on domestic violence and break the silence. Domestic violence is when someone makes the choice to have power and control over their present and or previous intimate partners, during or after the relationship ends, and it has impact on the child and family functioning. Despite violence being in the name, there's often no physical violence involved, as they are able to control their intimate partners by other means, such as intimidating, threatening, minimizing, blaming, isolation, name-calling, or by being verbally, emotionally, sexually, financially abusive or controlling. Historically in CFS, we didn't always get involved in domestic violence situations. We thought, like most of society, that it was an adult-to-adult issue, that it was a relationship issue, happening behind closed doors, and that because the children were sleeping or at school, it didn't impact them. Boy, were we wrong. Children are impacted hugely by domestic violence, physically, emotionally, psychologically, socially, even when they aren't a witness to it. Look, we didn't know how it was impacting children and families, but we do now. And we've made changes to how we work with families when domestic violence is a concern. We've implemented a domestic violence-informed practice into our work. We work with the perpetrators of domestic violence, the ones making a parenting choice to harm their intimate partner and impact their children. We seek out their patterns of coercive control, their actions that directly and indirectly harm the child. Our goal is for the perpetrator to change their behavior. We engage with them because abuse does not stop on its own. If it were easy to change, it would have happened already. Without intervention, abuse tends to increase in frequency and severity, so we must find out their patterns and help them build a plan to make real behavioral change, to reduce the harm and impact to their children. We partner with the survivor of domestic violence. We need to understand all the actions they have done to keep their children safe and well cared for. And we need them to understand that they are not to blame for the harm their partner has caused. Our domestic violence-informed practice is a child-centered and strength-based approach, and our bottom line is child safety. When children are affected by domestic violence, they need three things: safety, stability, and the ability to share their story. We know that children do best when they are with their non-offending parent, so partnering with the survivor is paramount to assess if that can happen. Sometimes, the perpetrator's behaviors are so severe that survivors in CFS cannot keep the children safe with the parents, and alternative arrangements may be necessary. We know that domestic violence isn't just a family matter, it's a social matter. Domestic violence affects all of us. Families need your help. They need help from their family, friends, and the community. Perpetrators need people in their life who will hold them accountable for their actions and to help them make changes in their behaviors. Survivors need to feel heard, to be empowered, to know that they are not to blame, and they need to have hope. Children need safety and nurturance, and to have trusted adults with whom they can share their story with. Together, we can end domestic violence. What are you willing to do? Are you willing to end the secrecy of domestic violence? Are you willing to step forward and be part of the family support network? Are you willing to say no more to a family member or friend who is a perpetrator of domestic violence? Are you willing to not blame a survivor, but rather support and encourage them? Are you willing to be that trusted adult for a child because they need you? Are you willing to stand up against domestic violence?